The hallmark of the Westminster educational program is the choral experience. Every student on this campus sings in a choir every day during his 4 years of study. The freshmen must sing as a class in the chapel choir, the sophomores in the oratorio choir, and the junior, senior, and graduate students sing in the symphonic choir, which performs with the major orchestras on the East Coast. In addition to this daily required choral experience, there are three groups which are open on an audition basis: the chamber singers, Collegium Musicum, and the touring Westminster Choir. One of the things that distinguishes the Westminster choral program of the 1970s from that of earlier years is the diversity of approach which the three members of the conducting faculty bring to their daily classes and performances. In a sense, it is this eclecticism in all respects which creates a dynamic and exciting learning environment. This is nowhere better illustrated than in the actual excerpts from these various choirs. First, we hear the chapel choir under Robert Simpson rehearsing David Hugh Jones' God is a Spirit, which was written for the Dayton Westminster Choir in the 1920s and is still sung by the chapel choir on tour in 1976. And now the oratorio choir, under Dennis Schrock, singing a section of Jonah by Carissimi. Oh, Westminster Choir is presently the only collegiate choral ensemble under professional management. During the 1971-72 concert season, Roger Wagner was engaged to conduct Westminster Choir. His tour was under the management of Saul Hurock. That season also marked the year when Joseph Flummerfelt joined the Westminster staff. We now hear two excerpts from that tour program, one conducted by Roger Wagner and the other by Dr. Flummerfelt. Roger Wagner is conducting the 16th century chanson by Passerolle, Illy Bailly Bon. The Westminster Choir under Dr. Joseph Flummerfelt follows in a performance of the chanson by Claude Debussy.
Illy Bailly Bon, which means he is handsome and good, quote, my husband. Two women are talking on the marketplace, and one says to the other, my husband is handsome and good because he does all of the housework. He feeds the chickens, and you will hear the chickens in the piece. He feeds the chickens, and he never beats me. Three good qualities of a 16th century husband.
The music festival is a very important part of American concert life. From the mid-20s on, Westminster has sponsored festivals, the many Talbot festivals in Dayton, Ithaca, and Princeton, the contemporary music festivals of the 1930s, and recently the Franz Liszt Festival, a Schoenberg festival for the centennial of that composer's birth, and an American music festival in 1976, which marked the combined celebrations of the country's bicentennial and Westminster's 50th anniversary. Joan Lippincott now plays a section of Arnold Schoenberg's only organ piece, Variations on a Recitative. This is followed by the 1975-76 Westminster Choir under Joseph Flummerfelt singing Irving Fine's Have You Seen the White Lily Grow? This was taped in April 1976 and represents the most recent sound of Westminster Choir.
Thank you.
all men will be brothers, brothers beyond the stars. These thoughts of Schiller, set to Beethoven's incomparable score, written over 150 years ago, and as modern as today, have been performed numerous times with many orchestras by various Westminster choirs. What a fitting way to end our 50 years of reminiscence and look to Westminster's future. In the future lie more performances, perhaps for international audiences, of the great masterworks of the past, along with scores not yet written. Westminster's excellence in the singing of the a cappella literature, with a sound that is distinctive to this institution, is a heritage that dates back to the Renaissance. May future students carry on this tradition with principles laid down by the college's founders. May their voices crescendo in a great symphony of sound, and may they teach others to do likewise. And when the sound subsides, may they sing the benediction as Catherine Hauck Talbot heard it sung by Westminster Choir every New Year's Eve as the old year slipped into the new.